Hello, good morning everyone. Hope you all are well. I'm Gagandeep. I'm an MBA student at Leeds Beckett University, where I'm pursuing my master's. So as an MBA student, we have got a module which is marketing dynamics, where we have to make a vlog as well as a PPT on the three theories from our module. So as I've selected three theories from my module, which are pestle analysis, Porterfield forces model, as well as marketing research. So today I'll give you all the brief information about these three theories. So let's get started with pestle analysis. What is pestle analysis? Pestle analysis stands for political, economical, social, technological, legal, and environmental factors. So let's get started with pestle analysis. So in this video, I'll talk about three different things about the pestle analysis, like what is pestle analysis. Second one will be advantages as well as the disadvantages of pestle analysis. And the last but not least is how LDU's pestle analysis study. So let's get started with what is pestle analysis. A pestle analysis is a framework to analyze these important factors which can influence an organization from the external side. It is a very useful tool for any organization or any business, you can say, to understand their external environment. The main aim of this study is to figure out that how different factors can influence any organization or business performance. So now let's start it with various disadvantages of pestle analysis. So let's get started. You know, it is a very flexible to change, so it can be easily changed in a minute, so which can create problems for any organization, or you can say that which can create a problems for the large portfolio industries, which is not a good thing for them. Another one is it doesn't provide full picture of any situation. It is understandable that it is very simple. Simple is not every time, it's not always good, because it can also give us some stress about anything. Mostly data we cannot find easily, so this is the biggest disadvantage, that we cannot able to find a lot of the data online. I will talk about how LDU uses pestle analysis. So let's get started with, as we know that about the pandemic of COVID-19, that it affects the lifestyle of every people in our every country. Because of this virus, more than 50% of economy falls at a very devastating rate, which results in decreasing the job opportunities as well as changing the habits of buying, as they do not want now the expensive things for their daily use, which is very crucial to survive for anyone. So nowadays, mostly people want good quality food at a very reasonable price, because they do not have too much money. Because of problems occurs, you can say that because of pandemic, hence LD uses a rational model approach to reach their goal, which is providing better quality of food to their customers and earn a good profit at that only. Firstly, you know, an LD manager can try to maximize their productivity. Know that we have done the study about the pestle analysis. So now I will talk about Porterfield forces model. As we know that Porterfield forces is a model which is used in business to identify and analyze five competitive forces that gives shape to every business, you can say, or every organization. It also helps us to determine the weaknesses and strengths of business. As it is clearly understandable that this was developed by Michael Porter. Hence, I can say that Porterfield forces is used to identify the strengths of an organization's current position and strengths where they want to reach in future. Let's start it with their advantages as well as the disadvantages. What are some advantages and disadvantages of Porterfield forces model? Let's get started with advantages of this model. So the first one is, the most significant strength of this model is that it is well known and commonly used method in strategic management after the 20 years of introduction, which has been experienced by many researchers in their theory. And another one is that it is a very simple model, so it can be easily used and provide understandable way of market force analysis. Last but not least is that it provides us the useful information for the issues in any company's planning. Hence, the company has the power to come up with the improving its competitive planning, which helps to increase the profitability. Now I will talk about various disadvantages of this study. So the first one is, it is too generalistic and analytical framework, which gives us a list of factors which might can advantages or disadvantages. For we have to start with how LD uses Porterfield forces model. As we know that LD is a big supermarket because a lot of people or a lot of customers have shifted to LD from like Morrisons or Tesco because their prices are too much high rather than LD. So LD have to focus on innovation to of different products from the threats of new entrants, so their customer will not shift it to another supermarkets because they are getting the innovative techniques products in LD as well. They can also focus on providing greater quality products at a lower prices than their own competitors such as Morrisons, Tesco, so that buyers will automatically choose the good quality product at lower prices rather than same at higher prices. Because if I am an international student, I will prefer the lower price food because I can only bear that one. So they do not want to spend more money when they can spend the lower price for same products. Our last theory is marketing research. What is marketing research? Marketing research is the process of gathering, analyzing, interpreting various information which helps the marketers to solve specific marketing problems or to take advantage of marketing opportunities. As we know that it is clearly understandable that research is one of the most important tools in any business. It is the way in which an organization such as LD, Morrisons, Lidl, etc. so that they can find out what their customer wants and what are their needs for any particular product. So through marketing research is the foundation element of modern marketing practice. There are many types of marketing research, but most common which we use in our theory is primary, secondary, qualitative and quantitative research. Moreover, we mostly use interviews as well as survey for these researches. Advantages of marketing research. It helps us to guide your communication, as we know that we have the research results, so we can apply the most effective way to communicate with our potential customers to know about their wishes and wants about any product, any particular product. The second one is it helps businesses to strengthen their position in market, as we know that market research can also helps to gain a better and prospective understanding of our target audience, which automatically helps to increase the volume of sales. It also helps us to discover our competitors' strengths and weaknesses, which is very good for any organization to have the knowledge of that. Last but not least is that it should focus on customer needs and demands. The main outcome of marketing research is that it provides our customers a better quality products as per their needs, which helps to reach their organization goals. So, how LD uses marketing research to increase their sales and reputation? As we know that LD is a famous supermarket which uses different methods to improve their sales and profit margins with providing the better quality of food to their customer at a very reasonable price. Let us take an example. As we are international students, though we cannot afford too much expensive products of daily life because we are having the limited income per month. So our spending budget is not that much high. So we are students and we prefer to go to LD because it provides cheap and good quality products rather than preferring Tesco or Morrisons, I can say, because they are having the high prices. So we will choose LD over the Morrisons as well as Tesco. To sum up, as you all know that I have a talk with all of you about the three theories of my marketing dynamics module, which was pestle analysis, Porter five forces model, as well as the marketing research. So now I'm gonna end this vlog. Hope you guys like it. Thank you so much. Bye bye. Take care.